Okay, here's one I didn't know. Monkeys.
Monkeys? A hutch.
Clamor.
Clamor.
A
I don't
barrel or a
a barrel.
troop?
A
I've heard
barrel
of
of
troop,
monkeys.
but a
Troop,
barrel is
yeah.
more common.
Well, troop is what they call a bunch of baboons. Troop of
Yeah.
baboons. No monkeys, a barrel of monkeys. It's more fun than a barrel of monkeys. Well, that makes total sense now, that whole saying. I get it.
Yeah.
Wow.
Okay, so crows are a murder. You know what
Yeah.
ravens are? And I've heard this too. An unkindness. So I guess, you know, there's one step up from misdemeanor to felony, ravens and crows. Shh, your brother's trying to sleep.
Is that B digital to anybody else?
Yes.
Tell him to floss. Can he floss? Does he know how to floss?
Do you know how to floss?
Yes.
Do it. Do it. Yeah, buddy. Need to loosen up those hips a little bit, though.
He dances like his dad.
Loosen
It'll
up
never
those
happen.
hips. Hey, dude, you still dance better than Jake ever did.
Well, that's true, but I don't have epileptic seizures on the dance floor either.
Daddy, you're cheating.
Yeah, I know. We were reading them because it was fun and we were passing time. You know what they call a group of crows?
Yeah, a murder.
Very good.
They call a group of crows a murder. I know it sounds odd, but they do.
Ask him if he knows ravens.
You know what they call a group of ravens?
Bad luck.
Never moss.
Close. An unkindness. You know what they call a group of
Hippopotamus.
hippos? A bloat. All right, go to bed.
Want to say
Okay.
hi.
Hey,
Hi.
kiddo.
Hello.
How you doing?
Hello. Good.
We're gonna have you guys over to see our new house sometime soon.
Good.
Yeah, we got a pool and everything, buddy.
For real?
Yeah, man.
That's pretty cool.
It's a sweet pool, man.
Have you even went in it yet?
Not yet, it's too cold. It's like the thermometer is saying 66.
The answer should be you never go in it.
Oh, that's not true.
Actually,
No,
you're
never
right. You're.
go in it.
Har 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 har
Oh.
har.
Goodbye. Okay, yeah, you don't go in the pool.
That sounded like a dad joke.
It was.
It definitely
It
was.
wasn't even a dad joke.
Right. See you guys. Good
Night.
night. Good night. I was about to roll this up.
All right. So when last we were with our heroes,
Right, of
yes.
course.
Barrackhole made a bad choice.
Again?
What?
Barrackhole
What
else
doesn't
is
do
new?
that.
Bed, go to bed.
What did I run off and hit this time?
Love you.
Little stone dudes, and now we're all trapped on a bridge about to be murdered.
Wonderful.
Yeah, he's going to bed too. Good night. Good night.
All right, Ethan, you need to go
Ricky
to
says
bed.
hi. Ethan. Ricky says hi.
Ethan says hi to Ricky.
Okay. He's
Okay.
going to bed now.
A bunch of stone dudes.
Yep.
Why
Did
did
we wipe them out though? Or are they just leading us on?
No, you guys were in the middle of fighting them, and then the hook horrors showed up. These were the things you were fighting.
Just to clarify, though, I'm pretty sure those guys can climb, but they're down in a ravine currently. Okay.
Yes, for the moment.
It is 40 feet down, so they have a little ways to go, but they are very large creatures and they can climb.
Okay, so I guess it's barricades go.
Yes. Your turn.
All right. If I move one step to the right, I have an attack of opportunity from the one on the left, correct?
Yes.
Right. Let's see here. going to try. Let me open this up real quick. One just a sec. To knock this one down. Nice. Tell me if he
withstood that. He did not pass his second throw.
Okay. Then he goes down. The next attack is at an advantage.
But can you roll damage?
Yes. Yes, that would be good.
James, is your mic on your headset working, or do you have a different mic?
I'm sorry?
Are we hearing the mic on your headset, or is there a different mic, like on your camera or something? No.
Yeah.
Yeah, there you is. Your headset mic's not working.
Now I just gotta remember how to switch that.
I guess I should have rolled damage on Ethan. Go. Thanks, Rick.
Dude, Ricky does that shit all day long. All day. That and the stupid dab
thing. Oh, the dab thing just kills me. I wanna.
We're going down Home Depot. He's like, I'm doing the side dab. I'm like, what the hell are you talking about? There it is.
Did this work?
Hey, Barakal, you still didn't actually do damage.
Yeah, I know. I was kind of waiting on James. I hit the wrong button and I figured, to hell with it, that's my next attack. So I got to roll damage twice.
Yep, but now you need to figure out how to make your damage to a critical.
Oh, shit.
Well, you should have listened to me when I told you to roll damage.
I hit the wrong button. It's not like I meant to disobey. It was disobedience by mistake.
Gee, Shane.
Okay, so if you click the little plus minus that's up in the top right, there's a damage modifier in there. You can click critical and then roll that.
Where? In the top right.
Top right.
There's a plus minus.
Combat tracker is.
Good night, Ethan. Go. Critical. There we go. All right, Ethan, whatever mom said. All right, take that, and then take that.
Okay.
And then I've got one more. Oh, did either one of those hit?
It is a hit, yes.
Oh, sweet. And then last one. Okay.
Okay. Where's the guy that you're hitting? Okay, cool.
I have no idea how your character works. You just like, I'm gonna go again. I'm gonna go again. I'm gonna go again. Yeah. Again.
Attack. Oh, bonus attack. Flurry of blows. Second attack.
And again, and again, and again.
And again, and again, and again.
Yeah, that's all I see. As long as you keep hitting, I'm fine with that. It's just, I couldn't run your character.
It took a while, and there's some stuff we had to build specially on there. The prone attacks and stuff. Oh, I didn't need to mark off a key point. So yeah, it can be a pain in the butt, that's for sure.
Okay. He's gonna run over there, gonna start climbing.
Is anybody just getting a weird noise out of Discord?
It sounds like there's like, well, it's
but
it doesn't.
Very digital.
It's really staticky.
It sounds very staticky and not bird-like.
Oh, it sounds staticky.
I guess that's the best way to describe it.
Yeah, and the
imagine a
really
horrible cell phone call, but weird squeaky bird noises over it instead. It's very digitized staticky.
Yeah, it's been
chirping.
It's been like that for about 4 or 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Okay, hang on a second. Let me What does that sound like?
Staticky.
That sounded staticky. Like a Pokemon.
It sounded like a...
I mean, that's what I clicked. Static. Pokemon sound. So,
yeah, the old school Game Boy, like you have 3 bits of sound to play with. Yeah, that's what it sounded like.
Yeah, I mean, is that what we're looking for the quality of this game?
Yeah, absolutely.
Now I just gotta remember, how did I switch servers last time?
It says you're on US East, and it says that it's running decent.
It lies. Yeah. Obviously.
What are you showing for your pings? That's clear.
That was
better,
clear?
That was better.
Huzzah, hurrah, or something like that.
What is
it? Still stuttered a little bit.
It was clean on mine.
I'm still getting bad stutter.
Yeah, I am too now.
Yeah, it says East 620 is showing a ping of 41 milliseconds, but it does not sound like it.
See, I'm showing
400, 500 range.
I'm showing 52 and 53 milliseconds. But hey, not a big deal to me, man.
Yeah, I know. I just want to make it. All right, I just switched servers.
So,
has anything changed?
No.
I don't know what that noise is, but the music you're playing came through clear.
That?
It's clean.
That's clean.
That bird noise does not sound like a bird, though.
No, it's like meh, 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 meh. It's like a sheep and a duck mated.
Not really supposed to sound like a bird.
Okay.
I mean, hookcores aren't exactly birds, but no, actually, I'm using a mimic sound because I couldn't find. I'm sorry, not mimic. Shoot, what are the bird race? Starts with a K.
I know what you're talking about.
Crap, I can't remember the name, but yeah, they're supposed to be able to mimic voices.
Like the things in Hunger Games.
Kind of.
Jabberjays?
But there is a race in D&D, starts with a K.
Kukulaka something.
Something like that.
Mockingjays.
But, yeah. I couldn't actually find the sounds that I was using for the hookcores last game. I searched for about a good 30 minutes, and I was just like, you know what, fine. Here, this is the closest that I got.
It sounds like a sheep and a duck mated.
Yeah.
I guess, yeah. That makes sense. Sounds like...
So there's some music playing also?
Yeah.
Okay.
What the hell hit me that
they punched you in the face a bunch of times?
A bunch or just one?
Well, they each took turns punching you in the face.
Okay.
I think they get, what, two attacks, James?
And I mean, the amount of times that you were stepping off last game, too, the players decided to go ahead and start doing the same.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think they're not up yet, so I can't see their character sheet. Okay, there we go. Yes, they can make multiple attacks. Alright. Anyways, so yeah, the hookcore, he moves down there. Oops, crap. Screen went off. He moves down there, he starts climbing up the wall. Climbing up that wall.
Great. How big are these little stone guys?
They're medium creatures. All right, Ro, you're up.
Okay. 30-foot cube. 30-foot cube. Okay. So, how do I make a thingy? Pointers, yes. I want this one. Yes. Can I rotate this somehow?
Yes.
I lost my center.
The end. You can rotate it.
There we go.
Yeah, let's try not to just include me in the middle of that.
Well, I can't grab the center of it anymore. I think it's under one of the birds. Okay, well, just imagine that it's about 5 feet that way. It's off a thing anyways. Okay, there. Yeah, okay, so I'm hitting those four. So I am going to cast Hypnotic Pattern once I can get to my character. There we go. Okay.
Everything all right, Donna?
And they all fail.
Good. Very nice. All right. So those guys are done. And I guess I'm just going to stay. Wait, they're not actually up here yet, right?
No. Those four that are down there?
So
No, they're not up
if I
there.
move.
Oh, yeah, they're still climbing. That's. Sorry, misunderstood who you meant by they.
Sorry. Yeah, I guess I could have, specified. So about how fast do they look like they're climbing?
30 feet.
So like they'll
It
be
looks
here
like their
next
climb
turn.
move is just as fast as their run move.
Okay. I guess it's gonna be safer to be on the bridge with everybody else, so I'm gonna move here.
How far down is that lower level?
40 feet.
Right, and it's my turn.
All right, Grimble, what you done?
They're incapacitated, would they fall?
If they were
They're on the
up in
ground.
the air, they're on the ground though.
Okay.
I'm gonna move right there, and I'm gonna cast haste on myself.
Okay.
Oops, hold on. Sorry.
He's gonna run away from you guys. That's all haste does?
That's all I'm doing right now.
Okay.
I'm not gonna get caught in the middle of the bridge, in between, hook horrors on both sides.
Gotcha. Fair enough. All right.
That was me evading, if you were just wondering why I was spinning around.
Oh.
No one really was, but thanks.
No problem. Damn. 12 points of damage?
So yeah, it basically swings at its arm. You miss.
Which one? Eight?
Yeah, the one to the left. And brings across its other arm. And that one connected.
Now the four has to stand up. Is that an attack of opportunity or no?
Nope.
Okay, I couldn't remember. It's been a while.
Got to remember how to remove that. There we go. Yeah, so when it. What just happened? Why did the screen completely change? I think there was an update to Fantasy Grounds, and I'm not aware of this.
I mean, I had to update when I logged in, but.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I'm sorry. I'm aware that there was an update, but screen looks completely different. I mean, it's kind of cool. Oh, I can open up multiple screens now. On the GM combat tracker, I used to only be able to open up one of those combat pieces a turn. Or I'm sorry, I just had to click on the one, and then if I wanted to see something else, I had to click on another. Now it allows me to open up two, and it expands it. That's kind of cool. Okay. Anyways, so yes, basically you see the rocks kind of like disconnect and reform as it stands up. And it takes its swing.
Damn.
18 hit?
Say again?
18 hit? Tell me that. I thought that you had higher.
No, because I don't have any kind of armor. I don't know. My AC is 17.
Oh, okay.
Let me double check. 10, 4, 17, yeah.
Alright, so yeah, it swings its rocky arms, connects both times.
That tunnel that's over there behind those rock guys,
uh-huh.
How tall is it?
That's a good question. Ceilings are 30 feet high.
In the tunnel?
Yeah, in there.
And it's what, about 10 feet wide or so?
Yeah, it's roughly 10 feet-ish wide.
And you said these Galeb guys are medium? What does that mean, like 5, 6 feet tall?
Yeah.
Barakal, how tall are you again?
4'7", 4'8". I'll tell you.
Alrighty, we're going to try something, and James can tell me how
4'8".
Spectacular or how awful this goes.
I mean, I'm always willing for you to just try something in the dark. We'll see what happens from there.
Alrighty, so what I want to do is I'm going to kind of yell at Barakal, don't move. And I'm going to try and run, use his shoulder to kind of push off of, and go over him, over the Galebs, so I can be on the backside of them.
Okay, so what you're trying to do there, it's called an overrun or tumble. And so basically you can make an athletics or an athletics check to get past them. Right, you can move freely through your people, but through...
But to move over or around somebody else is a check. Yep. So... Is that just like on the main skills thing? Just like an ability check?
Yeah.
Yeah, athletics or...
Acrobatics.
Okay. Which other one so is better strength, for strength or dex, right?
Pretty much.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna try it because I'm also going to heal you in the process.
Ooh.
Since I have to make contact with you.
Can I assist by giving him a boost?
Sure, but well, actually, no. You've already used your turn, but he's pretty much. I'm pretty sure he's gonna use his athletics.
Yeah, I'm stronger than I am dexterous, so. Where did my healing spell go? That's cure wounds. Oh, wait, wrong one.
By the way, it takes a bonus action to do a tumble or overrun.
Okay. All right. And then I myself get... I don't know if that matters at all. And then we're going to find out where I land. 15?
Yep.
Is that good enough?
You did not roll your athletics, but yeah, that's good enough still anyway.
What do you mean I didn't roll my athletics?
You rolled strength.
Yeah, you just rolled your strength. Your athletics, you get a +7.
Oh.
So that would have been a 20.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, you
that's a big difference. Okay. So I heal him and I'm over here now.
Cool.
And that's gonna be my turn. And I'm gonna kinda shout, let's get on this side of the tunnel. Bottleneck.
Okay. Yep, you guys all hear that. How long are these guys incapacitated?
Up to a minute, as long as I concentrate and they don't get hit by something.
Cool. All right. Yep. They are down there doing their incapacitated stuff. This guy's going to start climbing. 5, 15. Yep. So I'm just going to scatter them like that as it's climbing up. And now we're back to Barakal.
All right. N- Now, a tumble is a bonus action, you said? So I can do the same thing Leokis did, basically, correct?
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
Okay. I am going to do it. I'm going to tumble to Leokis's left, or attempt to tumble.
Ooh. Good enough? Yep.
Good enough?
Yep.
Okay. And now, no, I'm not going to do that. Now I'm just going to attack, and I'm going to attack the same guy, but this probably won't work. I'm going to try it anyway. Let me open this up. And that hits. Is he affected? Knockback. Did he save?
He saved.
Shit. I was hoping I could kick him off onto the hook horn.
Oh, nice.
I didn't figure there was much of a chance, but hey. Damage. Okay.
Okay.
That's it.
There we go. All right. So 12. 12 goes ahead and makes it on up. And he pulls himself up and he starts crawling over quickly towards Grimble. Yeah, he slams both of his hooks down. Misses Grimble. One of them, Grimble's able to knock out of the way with a shield. 15. Pulls himself up, but he creates a problem for 16. 16 has nowhere to go.
Let's see, if we could dislodge that one, that would be great. If we had knocked that one guy I've already hit down, that would just be phenomenal.
Yep, and as he comes up, he actually grabs like his hooks link into Leokis's legs as he pulls back, and you feel a little bit of shedding of your armor. You start his climb.
Now, just so that I'm clear, shedding is like a flavor thing. I'm not actually losing.
No.
Okay, cool.
You'll be able to adjust and correct it later. Not a big deal.
All right, so I don't have any fancy way to vault through these guys, so I'm not so sure about me going over there.
I mean, if you have athletics or acrobatics.
Or a grease spill.
I mean, man, you have one better than Nathan had when he did it.
How large are the hook horse? Are they large?
Yeah.
I guess... I don't know. Can I share a square with, like, Barakul, I guess?
Yeah, you're
going to share a square with the teammate.
Yeah. Sorry, I don't have a square to spare.
Okay, so I guess I'm going to tumble into you. Hopefully. Let's see how this goes.
Hey, it's better than I did.
Good enough.
Ba-choo! Okay. And then,
what was your tides for? Oh, you used your tides. Actually, I already casted that. You're blue. Don't forget.
I am blue. I hope they don't freak out. I didn't click anything for that though.
Good. No, that was just your effect was still on, and it gave me a reminder.
Oh, okay. All right, and then I guess I'm going to, let's see. Is there a way, since I'm like sharing a square here, that I can hit all three of those with a cone of cold?
I mean, yeah, you'd put it on the the corner of
like
where...
if I went like from here and then across sort of thing.
I can't see your mouse, but I think I know what you're trying to do. Yeah, you would put it on the corner of where you and Barrick will share.
Okay. All right. So I'm going to cast Cone of Cold.
They all succeeded.
Okay, yes. But it should still do the half damage, right?
I think so.
When I roll it? Okay.
Yeah, and save for half. Okay. Unless they've got some kind of immunities. Hey, we'll take 20 points of damage all day long.
Yep.
Okay.
Okay, and... it shatters, the guy right in front of Leucus.
He shatters?
He shatters.
Damn it, I was going to roll his dead body over the edge and try to knock out the one that's climbing.
Okay.
We still got one more.
Yeah, this is true.
All right, Grimble, what you doing?
I am attacking this guy right here in front of me. Select him. Three attacks. So first one, not gonna do it.
The first one actually hit.
Did it really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Second one missed though, right?
Yes.
Okay, so let me roll damage for the first one here.
Yeah.
Okay. And then my last one here. Boom, that'll do it. And I shall also Divine Smite this bee. Just first level here. Let's see what happens.
Nice.
Okay. And that's it for me.
All right. This guy gonna continue attacking on Barrickle.
Hmm.
So yeah, it starts slamming its stone fist down on you. Leucus. I'm not hearing you.
Mute helps.
Test.
Yep, there we go. All
right. I think
I can heal myself for 36 next turn.
That's kind of what I was thinking. I think I'm going to try and take care of this hook, or if I can shove him off the edge. Maybe. We'll see. So I'm going to take a swing with a Warhammer.
That missed.
That does not hit, right?
Correct.
Okay. Well, let's see. I believe my feat says as long as I take the attack action. Where did that go? That's the wrong one. One second. I want to make sure I'm doing this right.
If this was a live game, I would have totally scared Aaron by now.
Unfortunately, it still doesn't work.
Yeah, I know. Well... I tried.
But I appreciate it.
Where is it? I know you have it.
I know, and I'm looking for it, and I'm not seeing it. Oh, yeah, here we go. It was right at the top. I just skipped over it.
Oh.
If you take the attack action.
I'm looking at your features and not your feats.
Yeah, if you take the attack action on your turn, you can use a bonus action to try and show a creature.
Yep. Okay.
All right, so I tried to attack. That didn't work. I'm going to try and shove the hook horror kind of off the ledge and maybe see if I can't have him bump into the other guy behind him.
Okay. Shoving is an athletics versus an athrobiletics check.
Yep. Now, is that the
athletics? You get to make an athletics, skill? And I have to make it, yep. And I have to make an athrobiletics. You do it.
Huh.
Nice. Good job.
Okay. I'm going to kind of kick him off the ledge and okay. see if we yep. can't slam him into the other guy climbing up.
Absolutely. Yeah. He. Let's see. 40 feet. And... Oh, wait. He's 16. He's 15. I did that wrong. All right, yep. So, yeah, he's goes flying down, slams into the one beneath it, and they both hit the ground below.
Sweet.
With a nice little thud.
That's going to be my turn.
All right. These guys are still incapacitated. 16 is standing up and starts its climb again. All right, Barakol, you're up.
Wholeness of body is an action. Do I still get a bonus action as well?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to heal self. I feel much better. And now I'm going to pull out a handful of ball bearings and toss them in the square that the Caleb Dürer, is that it?
Yeah. Yes. Is the ball bearing thing a bonus action?
Is it an attack?
I
don't know.
Just a standard action.
Yeah, so would that be a bonus action? Or does a bonus action have to be specific?
Bonus actions are specifically stated.
Okay. Then that's all I'm going to do then, is just heal myself. And I'll put my ball bearings back into my pouch.
Tiny metal balls from your pouch.
As an action? Okay.
Yep.
All right. Thank you.
No problem.
And I'm done.
Okay. This thing's going to continue its attack on Grimble. It hits. Grimble passes his concentration. Its first one slams into the ground. The second hook comes across and clips you. You pass your concentration. And 15 is now standing up and starting its climb again. Two finishes its climb and gets up there. And pulls itself up to the top. Ro, what you doing?
Is the Earth dude in front of us... he's not the one that was unconscious, right? He's just fine.
I don't think he's been touched, actually.
No, I hit him with my cone of cold.
Yep.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
I guess I'm going to lob some rays at him. But I'm going to do it as a fourth level, so he'll get 4.
Well.
Okay, let me scroll up. How many bolts are you sending?
4. I'm casting at a fourth level spell.
1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So it hit, and two misses.
Okay.
All right. Did it have a fire? No, it doesn't have any immunities. Cool.
Okay. All right,
so yep, it gets hit. Grimble. All
right, let's let's finish off number 12 there.
Oh, not like that.
Not like that.
Close.
Shit.
That hits.
That'll do it. Oh, come on.
All right. How do you kill it?
Just nothing fancy, man. It's just hack and slash.
Okay. Yep. You rip its chest open. You see it start bleeding out and it falls down to the ground.
That's it, man.
And then Gilder.
Is that his name, or is that what it's called?
That's what it's called.
These guys have some hard hands. I'm jealous. Son of a bitch. Did he get two criticals?
No, he got one critical.
Okay.
That's not the one he rolled a 5 and a 2. But, it slams, and it was just the perfect line shot.
Yeah.
It hits you, and then it brings its other fist down on top of it.
I healed for 36, and he hit me for 30. It's like shit. All right.
They're kind of evil.
Something's got to happen with this guy.
Good. All right, let me guess once again. To you. I think you're muted still. Oh, never mind. I hear you.
Let's see if I can target correctly. Bear call. Yep. Alrighty, well, you're gonna get some more health.
Thank you.
Because this guy just keeps railing you in the face.
Yeah, I need to find something to improve my armor class. I'm telling you. Oh, that was awesome.
Oh, I cast that at a third level spell, not a fourth, just so you know.
Oh, okay.
I miscalculated.
Okay.
And I think that's all I can do. I don't think any of these are bonus action, if I remember right. Action. Oh. Nope, it would have to be a cantrip. That's going to be it.
Okay. So, fast save. All right, 16. Gets up there. So yeah, it starts just clawing its way at you.
That was two hits?
Yep.
Ouch.
Baracle, you're up.
Okay. That hit, did he fail?
It hit and he did fail, yes.
Oop.
What was the save against?
16.
No, what was the save against? What was it for?
Prone. He's now prone. And now we're going to do...
You going to roll your damage?
Damage. And we are going to hit him again. Ooh, that was close. One more. Whew. Getting the ones out of the way.
lucky for the prone.
Yeah. And then lastly, I'm going to spend another key point, and I'm really going to try to do this since he's prone. I'm hoping this will work. Oh,
he failed.
Damn it. He failed?
Was there an attack?
It was, but I accidentally hit the save instead of the attack button. Did he fail?
Well, he failed the save, but...
Okay, if I hit him with this, then it's a knockback. If I hit him with this, then we're in good shape.
Cool.
Which hits, because I've still got advantage. And he takes that for damage, and I kick him 15 feet off the ledge.
Okay.
So he got knocked down, kicked twice, and then punted like a football.
All right. And then he falls 40 feet.
Bitch. Hit me again.
Good luck climbing.
All right. 15 pulls himself up. Start swinging. Yes. Yep, 15. He's just having a hard time swinging around. 16, that's up there. 2, start swinging on Grimble. 2, just clawing right into his shield. Rowena, what are you doing?
I am going to kind of cold these guys again.
One succeeds, one fails. Looks like one took some heavy damage. The other one's in the critical condition.
Okay.
Grimble, you're up.
Right. I want to knock out this number 2 guy here. There we go. Check this out.
That hits?
Boom. That's not so good. All right, let's do it again.
No!
What happens?
You're fine.
Okay.
I'm not going to worry about it for the rest. Oh my god. I might start worrying about it if you keep rolling them, though.
We're getting all the ones out of the way, Rick, both of us.
Motherfucker. Yeah, well, that just kind of spins my turn. I'm done.
Yeah, so basically, when you swing your axe, basically the second time, it gets caught in its hook, and you're basically wrestling with it, and so you're trying. And it takes you, and it just slams you down to the ground. Your axe clings to the ground. You're going to be able to pull it free next time, or next
turn. Yeah, hey, I'm just going to be like... Gorm, why do you hate me?
I guess this is a lesson in humbleness. I don't know.
He lived through that fall, that little bastard.
Yeah, I was kind of impressed too.
And all the damage that he was dealing to him applied.
Yep.
I thought when I punted him off of that ledge, 15 out and 40 down, that was going to be the end of him. Damn. He's got like one hit.
Practically, yeah, because it's going to take him forever and a day to climb up that stupid mountain. It's really heavy.
I'll drop a ball bearing down. That'll be it.
All right. He starts his climb. We'll see you in a few rounds. All right, Lucas, what are you done?
Range spell attacks have disadvantage if I'm in their face, right?
Yes.
They're both up here?
Yes.
Well, I'm going to target the one that looks rougher if I can.
Okay.
And I need to stop targeting Barakal.
I appreciate that.
might be an interesting round.
I like
it. Oh, sorry about that, dude. Sorry about that.
We're in a really tight corners here.
We're really tight. This Warhammer gets a little unwieldy sometimes. Yeah, I'm going to take a swing at him.
Okay. That hits.
That hits. So he takes plus this.
Nice.
And where's he at? Can I try shoving him into his buddy again? Or is that going to be too much? They're too big for me to try that.
They're not really hanging much over the edge at this time.
They're not just going to go falling back.
If you knock one 5 feet, it will fall off, but it's not going to hit his buddy this time.
Okay. I can't shove the healthy one off, or is that... I can't tell where they're at. I don't know. I'll leave it.
I mean, they're just pretty much on top of each other, just clawing.
He's critical...
I mean, technically, you can shove either one of them.
I was going to say, I can do something to either one of them, right?
Yep.
It doesn't have to be the one that I swung at.
No, you're...
All right, I'm going to stop targeting him. I'm going to target you just for funsies. And I'm going to try and knock number 16 prone.
Okay. What do you have to do for that?
I don't know. Isn't it a contested thingy again?
Oh, I didn't know if like you had a special thing with your...
No, it's just part of that shield master. If I take an attack, I can either shove him or try and knock him prone.
Yeah, it's just an athletics versus an athrobaletics. And you succeed.
Okay.
Oh, nice.
And we still have not created a button for me, so if you can mark him prone. So that should be number 16 laying on the ground.
I gotta find 16 on here. There we go.
Cool. And that's my turn.
Damn it.
Awesome. All right. These guys are still out. 16.
Dope. I should have done the other guy. I was looking for the one that was a little healthier, but I wasn't thinking that he was just going to stand right back up.
Sorry.
Should have just pushed him off the edge.
How easy was it for him to knock him down, James?
He succeeded on the athrobaletic roll. Okay.
Didn't look like he was a pushover.
No.
Okay.
No. He just rolled much better than I did. So, depends on the luck, I guess. Yeah, he just starts clawing more into... Leah, because basically you slam him down to the ground, it just starts clawing and it's pulling itself up as it's clawing at you. He's still incapacitated. He's still incapacitated. Miracle, you're up.
Let me see. 15 and 16. Now, let me ask the same question that Nathan just asked you. If I hit one of them with knockback, which is 15 feet, will it take both or no? They're just on side by side, basically.
They're kind of side by side and like they're reaching over each other and stuff. I mean, it'll kind of nudge them, but it's not going to take them out.
Okay.
The only reason why I allowed it before is because he was directly below him.
And these are large creatures?
Yes.
I'm going to have to go with prone. What the just happened?
You have the Hakora and the Galeb targeted.
Oh.
So I will use the Hakora stuff that you rolled.
That's an impressive punch on that
game. That was really interesting. Fail,
and you hit. Go ahead and remove the target of the Galeb.
Yeah, I'm trying to find the... There he is. Okay, there we go. All right, so he's prone now, right?
You have to put that on him.
Oh, I thought it automatically did it. Did it not?
No, that's why you have the effect button.
Yeah, but it always puts it on in... Well, maybe not. Okay.
Maybe because the Galeb was the first in that list, it considered that one.
Maybe, because it should be automatic if he fails. Did that work? Or do I just need to drag it and drop it?
You should be... You have them targeted, so all you should have to do is just click the effect button. Okay.
All right. Yeah, it does it automatically on my end, I guess, because, like Nathan said... All right, now damage. Take that. Is he still up?
He is.
Okay, and I'm going to hit him again.
Okay, that hit. That damaged.
Third shot.
That hits. There you go. How do you finish him?
I just put the boots on him. I knock him down, and I just start stomping him, kicking him.
There you go.
And now I have one more attack. That was three, right?
Yep.
And where is... The other one is 16?
15.
15. Ah. Oh, no wonder I didn't think I was killing him. Standard strike.
That hits. And that finishes him.
All right, so I just put the boots to the other one, and I'm just gonna pop the other one in the head and kind of tumble him off the bridge.
Yeah.
Okay. Hold on, just a sec, guys.
Okay. This guy is going to do his attacks. All right, so number two over here, swings and misses, swings and hits and catches Grimble off guard. Grimble, you failed your concentration check.
Son of a bitch. For this, he will pay a great price.
Rowena.
Hmm. So after this round, I'm going to call out to Grimble that the other hook whores are going to be awake soon, and maybe he should come over towards us.
Okay.
And I guess I will actually cast it for real this time as a level 4 spell, my Scorching Ray at this guy. 120, right? Yeah, okay. All right, so that'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wow, only two of those hit?
You rolled a couple of ones. Yep, two hits.
Man, that's ugly. What is up with the dice tonight, huh? All
right.
And then... I am going to step behind these boys.
Okay. Cool.
And then...
Grimble.
It's go time.
As long as go time includes coming over by us.
It's go time.
I'll be there to help you in a minute.
I don't need any help.
Famous last words.
I'm Batman. Yeah.
It's gonna take you 10 rounds to crawl across the bridge? You have a height problem?
Okay. So, first things first. Hunter's mark. There. And now... Is he targeted? He is targeted. I'm going to divine smite.
Just a small amount of dice.
Nice.
All right.
One hell of a hit.
Let's give him another one.
That hit?
All right, this one's just a small one.
But it's just enough. All right. How do you kill it?
Well, I got pissed after he hit me that last time. So I snagged I just pulled real hard on the axe because he had the axe down trapped against the ground. So I yanked real hard. And since he had his hook in there, you know, I kind of threw him off balance. And I just kept the momentum going back around in an overhead chop, severed his arms, and then right across the throat there.
So nice. It was a
killing blow.
Nice. Yep.
Okay. And now I'm just going to sashay across this bridge.
Sashay? I'd love to see a dwarf in full armor sashay anywhere.
Yeah.
He sashayed out onto the bridge, not across the bridge.
Yeah, I tell you.
Two rounds later, he's finished sashaying.
I don't need any help. Corn.
That's great.
Okay, so it's going to take three rounds for this rock thing to climb up here, so I'm assuming you guys are going to walk away from this combat.
Just head away, because the time those hook horrors are going to... You're going to wait on it three rounds?
Well, no, I'm gonna start throwing darts down on him.
Oh, are you?
Yeah, okay. I got a ton of darts.
I think it would be an excellent idea to retreat at this point.
Because those guys will... Those four hook horrors are going to wake up about that time.
They're already awake. They're going to be coming now.
I thought that they weren't awake for a full minute.
Yeah, it's a whole minute. So you got to take that time.
All right. Then I am going to...
Well, I was thinking... Oh, we have three more rounds. Okay, yeah. My bad.
All right.
Storm is with us.
Can I just start throwing at him?
Yeah, I... How many darts can you throw around?
I don't... Two.
Okay.
But I'm pretty good with them. I mean,
yeah, so go ahead and start throwing them, and let's just...
First round.
Okay.
They both hit. Both hit, right?
There was only one.
He's still listed as prone.
Oh, I saw two dice. Okay, one hit. Let me take the prone. Oh, you have to take the prone off. I can't. So he hadn't started climbing. He's just laying there trying to catch his breath.
He got up and walked over, but
yeah,
he rolled across the floor too.
All right, so one hit, two hits. So he took 11 damage.
Okay. And there you go. So yeah, finally you're just like. And then the third one, it looks up at you as the dart comes down. It like opens its mouth to scream. It's like, and it crashes through its head. And it flies to the ground. By that time, I'm pretty sure Grimble has made it across. Are you guys leaving these hook horrors, or?
Yeah, let's leave those guys alone.
Yeah, okay. I agree. Can we take a minute?
You don't get XP per person, so.
Well, let's get a little further away before we decide to stop and rest. Let's maybe not rest at the opening of the tunnel.
Oh, come on. Where's your sense of adventure?
Getting warmed up. I have so much more smite to give.
All right, which way are you going?
I don't know. I just...
Oh, sorry. You can't see what I see.
Yeah, no.
I thought I opened it up already.
Do you see what I see?
Why can't I affect the mask?
Barakal, you're attacking while out of ammo.
What?
It's just something that popped up on the screen. You I know you had plenty of it. You had like 20 something when.
Yeah. I've actually got 21, and I threw four darts or three darts.
You threw three this round. I thought one was already missing, so.
No, I can only throw two around. So I threw two.
And then you threw a third one to kill him. So,
right. Yeah. So yes, you could go up.
So I'm down to 18. Oh. Which way do we go? Which way do we go? Wait, we didn't explore.
Can we hear anything one way or another?
Give me a Is it perception? Perception check.
All of us, or?
Sure.
Or do you want passive perception?
No, go ahead. All you guys roll it.
Shit, my passive perception's probably better. Yep, it is.
All right, Leicus, you definitely hear something stomping around up to the north, but you're not hearing anything to the left, west.
Didn't we get directions from the dude?
Yeah, we got directions at one point.
Yes.
From the guy that we freaked out.
And he told you to, because you guys were trying to find out where the god was.
Yeah.
Yep.
And he told you he's up in the northeast.
Okay. So probably not to the left.
But if you guys are looking for a place to rest for a little bit.
That's kind of what I'm going to just kind of put forth to the group. Like,
yeah, do you guys want me to stealth and check it out?
Well, it sounds like there's something big stomping around up north.
Yeah, I definitely need a nap or something.
All right, well, I wouldn't mind resting, you know.
Do you guys want me to sneak ahead and check out the corridor to the west?
Yeah, let's go west a little bit.
Okay. I'm going to roll stealth. And I am going to sneak, peek. I should be able to see 30 feet if there's no obstructions.
Yeah. Let me do this. That's not the what I want to do. That was just me being really bad at drawing on the screen.
Okay. What are these glowing crystals?
That's producing light in the room. This actually looks like it was some kind of room before. Like, either people like practice fighting here, or this was a meditation room.
Okay. I'm just going to step back and tell them what I see. There's a room up ahead. It's a lit chamber. I can't really see what's beyond it. If I walk through the light, we may be spotted, but it looks like it branches again past this next chamber.
Well, I'd say let's slowly creep our way in there and see where those branches go.
Maybe we should set up a little rest area in the lit section.
Yeah. Oracle's gonna go ahead and try to stay stealthed and kind of see what's around here.
If we can't sneak around in there, then nothing else should be able to either, right?
Well, we should be able to see 20 feet from the light source at least.
Mm-hmm. You're gonna look up a little bit to the north?
Yeah, I just want to see, you know, make sure we're not gonna get surprised as soon as we start resting.
Yeah.
What about to the right, north. Okay. Do you guys want me to check any further, or do we want to try to rest here?
Well, if you don't see anybody, let's at least get in here.
Okay. Yeah.
We'll see a little bit how far we can go.
All right.
Okay. So you guys get in there, and let's go ahead and take our first break.
All right.
See you guys in about 5.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's a technical term.
Yeah, I got you.
It's probably around Tuesday-ish that I finished the magic section, which I got really excited about because that was probably the biggest section of the book. But I think I'm lying to myself because I started looking at all I have to write up for the character creation and explaining each skill, explaining each background and what is this called? Advantages. And then explaining each flaw. That actually, I think, is going to be the more daunting section.
So, Rick, did I tell you that Donna's little brother Ricky bought a 2017 top end Camaro? He's putting turbos on it.
Really?
Yeah. So the turbos he got, it's a twin turbo system, up to 800 horsepower per turbo.
Jesus.
So he took it out tonight, try it out.
Wrap it around a pole?
No, not quite.
The hell is that? I can't tell what that is, man.
That's the wheel and the rotor. The center of the wheel.
What's left of it? Jesus.
What happened?
There's the outside of the wheel and the tire.
Torque, right?
Torque.
Torqued it right out.
Snapped the wheel. The right wheel planted. And he hit a guardrail. That's the front of the car. So my guess is...
Is he all right?
Oh, he's fine. My guess is he punched it. It broke that rear wheel, the left rear. The right wheel stuck, and he said all he knows is when he punched it, it went left into the guardrail. So I guarantee you that wheel just snapped, and the other one dug, and that was it.
Man, if he's going to go put some high-performance shit on the motor like that, he needs to make sure the rest of the car is high-performance to handle it.
Didn't I know? You remember the old one he had that we did that work on, put the cams in and the throttle body and everything? Two transmissions, two rear ends before he finally gave up on it. He kept tearing them out. And I told him, I said, you need to build for what motor you've got.
Yeah.
And we were talking about it today, and he's like, yeah, I think I'm going to run 12 pounds boost. I was like, man, I hope the rest of the car can handle it. He's like, yeah, it should be all right. Everybody says it'll be okay.
Who's everybody?
I guess all his buddies.
Where are these professional opinions that he's getting from?
I don't think
he's never gonna learn, man. I don't know. I don't think Ricky's the brightest bulb in the.
Oh, he's bright. He just is hard headed, dude. He wants to learn everything the hard way.
Oh, he is.
Yeah, wrap a $40,000 car into a guardrail, bust a wheel after you spent $10,000 on turbos.
Dude, tell me he didn't have his kids in the car.
He didn't. So, that's crazy, though.
Jeez, I've never seen a wheel rip out from the middle like that, man. That's pretty impressive.
I've seen a couple, but it's rare. I mean, it's rare.
That is impressive.
Because a side impact on a wheel, if you hit the bottom of the wheel, it'll break the bottom spokes, and the wheel will, warp a C shape. This is just, it's perfectly in line. It just... If you take a look, though, I mean, they're real thin spokes. They're only like that.
I was going to say, man, what are the odds that thing was, mismade?
It's possible.
It only probably takes one of them to fail with that amount of torque to just rip the rest of them clean out.
Yeah, because he's probably, that car was about 500 wheel horsepower. I have no idea what the torque was. It's probably close to 500 wheel horsepower before he put the twin turbos on it. So he's probably putting 800 to the rear tires. Nice car.
Does he even have the brakes for that?
Nice car.
What?
Brakes don't really have to upgrade too much when you're doing straight line stuff. You know, you just have to have a long straight track to slow down. If you're doing curvy stuff, then yeah, you got to upgrade all your brakes. But that's just, you put that much motor in anything, the weakest point's going to fail. First time you hit it, the weakest point's gonna fail.
I guess he found it.
Yeah. I did the same thing when I was 18.
Yep.
And I learned off that first time. Never did it again.
Okay, so are we taking a long-term or a long rest here?
I think we need to.
I mean, I agree, but I'm wondering if I should click the button or not.
Yeah, I was going to wait till James got back and ask him.
Oh, I didn't realize he disappeared.
Sorry, I'm here, but I'm just having a tough time with my dog trying to coax her to eat. She's a pain in the ass. And Jamie's not here to take care of her.
You've got to coax your dog to eat?
Effie, every now and then, she gets in this stupid mood, and then she doesn't eat. She's so small that she'll get sick.
So how do you coax her to eat?
I pretend like I'm about to steal it, and she starts eating because she's a dog and not smart.
That works. You
know? It does. Okay, so you guys are going to take a long rest?
Well, we think so.
Yeah. Okay.
Is Barricole going to roam any further up this tunnel?
Do you think it's prudent before we rest?
Maybe what could go wrong?
Well, you know.
I promise I won't fight anything. All right. When you're ready, James, I'll sneak forward just about another 40 feet or so.
Which tunnel are you going up?
I'll check the right one first.
All right. Give me
another stealth check.
But the first one was so good. And it's the same.
Okay.
And obviously I'm listening and peeking, trying to stay out of the light.
So that looks like it's looking into the room where there was a sound of something stomping around.
Okay.
You see up there one of these. What happened to my pictures? That's super frustrating. Gosh darn it. There we go.
Oh, you gotta be shit.
Yeah, you're seeing one of those?
Okay.
Do you guys know what that is? Because I've never seen those before.
Yeah.
I've seen folks on Critical Role fight one.
Okay. And I'm going to go right over here. Does it sound like more than one of those things stomping around?
Yes. If you're going to try to get in, it's too risky to get any closer.
Does it look huge or does it look gargantuan?
It looks large.
Large?
Yeah.
Okay.
I didn't think they were that big. I thought they were like medium-sized creatures.
But... No, they're large.
Are they?
Yep.
Okay. I thought they were huge. Okay. And now I'm going to peek up this tunnel. Okay. Do I see anything else there?
Nothing of interest.
Okay.
Stuff that's all the way up in the north is just a bunch of junk that's been compiled.
Okay. I'm going to sneak forward a little bit more and just make sure that drawing there is the wall, right?
To
the right? Okay. All right. I'm going to go back and report to the party and tell them what I see and say there's a better campsite further up the left path.
Let's go there. Let's camp among the junk.
Yeah, because right now we've got hook horrors behind us and bullets ahead of us. I'd rather have... although we have nowhere to go if that...
Yeah.
But I think I'd rather, you know, camp in a blind tunnel than in an intersection.
Okay.
You all, everybody agree with that? I guess so. Rowena does.
I'm gonna search through the stuff.
Okay. I actually don't know why they drew that, because they gave me nothing for that. They gave me more about the rest of the room. But so I'm just gonna go ahead and pretend that this section up here is what their description is. Because why not?
Okay.
All right, so you get up there. Actually, they gave me a very loose description. This is mostly me. Anyways, you get up there, you start looking around. You notice that there's like there's a lot of texture. It looks like this was once a room. There's like chimes that only of course make sound when you touch them. There's no real wind that's coming that's traveling through these caves, at least not in this section. What was that? Sorry, something just fell on my house.
Yeah.
I'll be right back, sorry.
No problem.
Yeah, I have that happen a lot to me in the middle of the night. It's usually one of the cats.
Yeah.
It's gotten to the point where I'm like, okay, if it's somebody, at least I have a gun next to the bed, and most likely they'll just steal whatever they want and leave, so it'll be okay.
Yeah, things are easy to replace.
Your cat is very preoccupied with something else in the room.
Yep, I don't know what, unless the other one's hiding somewhere, and I can't hear him because of my headphones.
I don't know. That cat is intense, though.
that is his constant state of being, is intense and concerned.
Yeah. Well, while James is doing that, I'm going to make sure Ethan's in bed. I'm just saying.
So I don't know if you two heard, but I'm going to be doing...
All right. That was a mystery thing that fell.
You didn't figure out what it was?
Nope.
Is it windy outside?
Not really.
So not like a stick on the roof or anything?
No. I don't know. And also because it was muffled because I had these headphones on. So I have no idea.
You'll find it like 3 days from now.
Yeah, probably. What happened to Jane?
He went to go check on his kid.
Ah, okay.
Oh, so they're primarily wanting to know about the pros and cons of playing... D&D online versus in person. So yeah, if you guys have anything, you can email me suggestions for that.
I think the only con that I can see for playing online is sometimes there are odd technical issues, especially when they update software and break things or completely modify how you're doing something.
Yep, I could totally back that one up.
I'd say both that and probably individual technical issues, too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Internet, power, all those kinds of fun things.
Yeah.
Scheduling.
Okay, cutting Shane's hard line.
Yeah.
I've still got two splices in there. Not only did they cut it at the top, they pulled up as much as they could underground and cut it at the bottom. So they cut about a 3-foot section out.
Jackass.
So, wow, that was like...
They really didn't want you to get past that.
Determined, yeah.
Well, we have had parking issues in our neighborhood, and I'm on the HOA board, and we started towing cars, so I'm sure that was a vengeful act. Yeah.
It's posted, don't park here. Your car won't get stolen or towed.
That's it.
It's a pretty straightforward concept.
I'd almost guarantee that's what happened. All right.
Did you talk to anybody else on the HOA and see if anybody else had it happen to him?
No, I did. Nobody else had that happen, but John Smith had some graffiti written on his house.
Wow.
So I think I'd rather have the other thing.
Yeah.
All right. I am going to go ahead. We can recover hit dice with the healer's kit, right, James? That's still the rule?
For a short rest, yeah. Well, you use hit dice.
I thought for long rests, you could just click the long rest heal button.
Oh, okay.
It may not full heal, but I could just heal us and then long rest, and it wouldn't matter, so.
Yeah.
Okay.
There you go. Let Leica's heal you guys, and then everybody do a long rest.
Okay.
Okay.
So you're looking around this room, and, yeah, there's a lot of textures. There's, like, ch- chimes that if you touch them, they make different, very, very unique sounds. You see some papers laying on like a desk. But yeah, this was definitely somebody's room.
That was fun.
Picking up the papers, unless anybody could read Braille.
Thanks, Leokis.
That's a fun little spell. I haven't had a chance to use that one yet.
What was it?
Mass cure wounds.
Oh.
Instead of mass healing word.
Nice.
Well,
James, you have the button to reset all the spells, right?
There.
I will target myself and finish.
There you go.
Thank you.
I just touched my...
Oh.
Oh, whoops. I did it early.
Yeah, I thought... Yeah.
Oh, well. We can just consider that I would have healed until I ran out of spell slots, so... I'm just going to go remove my wound.
Okay.
And Grimble, I would have made sure you were topped off, too.
You know what?
So, clear your wound also, Grimble.
That's weird.
What? Six.
My prone attack is only showing melee plus 6. It should be plus 8. Okay. That's wrong. Standard. Actions. Group summary. How do I edit this again, James?
So all of your open hand techniques are plus 8?
They should be, but one of them's plus 6.
So you click the little magnifying glass.
Oh, there it is. Thank you.
And then you click the other magnifying glass, and then you should be able to edit it.
There we go. Thank you.
Yep.
Okay, so you were the room textured or something?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it was somebody's room. You're seeing like a lot of textures, little chimes. There are some papers, but they're written in Braille.
So somebody was blind that lived here.
Some of you guys.
It was Toph. Sorry.
I wonder if Helen Ray was actually designed after Toph, just a bad guy. But yeah, some of you guys might be able to. Assume that this was Helen Ray's quarters. If you guys remember her.
She was the chick on the temple on the top side, right?
Yeah, she was the monk that whipped
that
our
destroyed
ass
us and put us in prison.
Yeah, enslaved us.
Just you might remember her.
Just a little.
Yeah.
I was gonna say she was the beat down in the snow, right? Where you chased her down.
Oh yeah.
I wish we could, you know, bring her back and do it again. That's how much I liked her.
Bring
all right.
Bring her back at whatever her level was with us now being stronger. There we go.
Yeah. I tell you, haste made all the difference with her. All
right.
Okay, so now looking at this map, guys, is there a couple of paths that we didn't take here?
Not without going back across
like
the bridge.
And we think that we need to go through these bullets? Is that our thought process here?
Well, they said northeast.
Northeast, yeah. So assuming he was telling us the truth, because we could go back before we got to the crystal part and go straight up north there.
But that goes to the same room, seems like, anyway.
We don't know that.
We could hear them. It may skirt the room that they're actually in.
Maybe.
Okay.
We could at least check and see.
Okay. And I'm thinking that there's two other rooms with exits leading to the northeast.
Yeah.
But okay.
So let's just see.
Do Do you want me to scout first?
Yes.
Yeah, you're the stealthy one.
Okay. Stealthy-ish. All right, James.
Out of our party.
Yeah. Hey,
and
another
again.
22.
All right.
I'm going to sneak forward very slowly, very carefully.
Okay. As you sneak forward, you look, and it looks like it is into the same room.
Okay.
You go ahead and open it up.
Are they still in there roaming around after we took our sleep?
Yep.
Does it look like it dead ends?
No.
No. Okay. Now that I can see in there, how many of these things do I see?
You see... you see four of them.
Hmm.
Some of them, the rock areas are kind of like cages. Not, like more like pens. And they're inside there.
Are the pins holding them in?
It just seems to be like their quarters.
Okay.
They're not technically restrained.
Okay. I'm gonna sneak.
Getting close enough, you're peeking in there, and you see there is a guy working with one. He's wearing the clothing of the earth cult. Oh. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I'm gonna go back down and tell everybody what I see. There's four of those, you know, burrowing monsters, and there's a member of the earth cult working with them. It's like he's their handler. There looks to be two passages out to the northeast.
I feel like we're gonna have to go through there.
Yeah, we could backtrack an awful lot. Now, James, that mud river back there, was that a wall?
No, yeah. It wasn't. Was it?
Yeah.
Okay. So okay. We would have to backtrack all the way back to, like,
well,
where the guy was eating the coins and go the other way.
What about in the area where the bridge is to the right?
You'd have to
is that a wall?
Climb down 40 feet.
That's a lot better than fighting four bullets.
Well, those hook horrors will still be there. We'll have to fight them.
Yeah, that's true. Hey, you know what we could do?
Get on the bridge and rain down shit.
Yeah, that's a possibility, but I was thinking that you guys can stay on the right-hand side. I'll go to the left, throw a few darts at the guy in the bullets, and then come back down, and y'all run up, and I'll just outdistance them and make a circle.
So that'll work if they all follow you.
Yeah, but they might not.
I was actually considering something similar with my greater invisibility, but I can only do that to two of us at most.
What if we were able to, like, so, like, this handler guy, he could be really bad for us. Like, if we kill him, those things may want to attack us.
But if we don't kill him, he's going
to
tell them to attack us.
He might sick them on us. Maybe we can make friends with him or charm him or something.
Hmm.
I mean, not everything has to be.
We got
to
have Rowena go in there again. Oh, my leg. It's hurting.
Maybe a different story this time.
I might be into.
I mean, it worked so well with the Earth cult last time.
What was it here, kitty kitty? Is that how it goes?
I mean, I could totally do it. I could. Actually, I have no idea.
Can
what,
you charm
what's...
anybody? Can you?
Oh yeah.
Hold them.
No, not like that. But I have a very high charisma.
Well, gotcha.
So do I, you know, but...
I do not have any charm spells. I have hypnotize, so I could go in there and try and catch all of them with hypnotic pattern and hope you guys can kill them one by one. before it ends.
Well, if they're hypnotized, we would probably just leave them there and run again.
Fair.
That's not gonna, like, hold person. I can keep them from running away, maybe. But...
then it doesn't affect the creatures.
Yeah.
See, where's Pappy right now? A dominate person.
Or his fey version of the black, icky, gooey death cloud thing.
Only you got one banishment.
I have banishment, but...
I also have banishment. Yeah, it'll only take out one of them.
But it'll take out him.
Yeah, I'm less worried about him than I am those things.
Well, they live underground in dirt, right? Do they... what's their eyes? Does anyone know anything about what these things are?
No.
That's a good question.
Not without metagaming.
James. Well, that's what I'm wondering. Is like,
what did your characters know about this? Does any characters want to make, like, a nature check or anything?
Well, I can try.
Certainly not me. You've at least seen them.
Negative one.
Oh, yeah,
yeah, I know nothing.
I got untrained. 17.
Okay.
Makes sense that a dwarf might know something about these. Oh, no, not really.
Well, dwarves do talk.
I mean, I don't
know.
I mean, these things have, like, do they have poor eyesight, or like, do they hate light?
I'm pretty positive they have tremor sense. But
well, I'd be certain of that, too.
Yeah.
But I'm just wondering if, like, would the spell, like, daylight disrupt them or something? Cause them to burrow into the ground and run away or something. I don't know.
I don't think they're moles.
Well, I don't, whatever, man. You know, I mean, they dig in the ground. It's like how they travel, right? You know what they look like?
Yep.
But the picture did have him coming out of the ground.
He's coming out of the.
Do you know, like, how, like, you know how a great white attacks a seal?
Yes. Oh, I know. That's exactly what I'm saying. You know, they're a shark in the.
A land shark.
Yes. Yes. In fact, I think that's what we used to call them, right?
Did we?
I think so. They're always called bullets, but...
yeah. I still like the idea of, you know, you guys stand on the right, and I'll run up and scream and throw some darts and get them to chase me and just go around and up and haul ass.
Alright, so, what you know about these things is their primary attack is a leap. Basically, they're just trying to slam creatures to the ground. They're pretty well protected with their heavy shell. Nothing too helpful on this character sheet. I mean, they're just pretty... they're basic monsters. They don't seem to have any kind of strengths or major strengths or weaknesses. They do burrow, though. They burrow just as fast as they move on land.
Yeah.
Does anyone have, like, levitation or something?
I can climb really well and run up walls.
I have reverse gravity, but that won't help us.
But it may hurt them.
It may stop them from...
I mean, to be fair, Rowena does have levitation if she glitches properly.
True. Chances of that aren't super great, though.
One in 100.
Yeah.
1 in 100 if the 100 ever happens, or if the check ever happens.
Yeah,
so...
I mean, I can get away, but I'm pretty sure the rest of y'all are fucked.
Yeah, the last time that I used reverse gravity with the earth things, they just went into the ceiling. So, it didn't work
great.
Yeah,
that's a good point.
They did kind of fall on us.
Can you, like, reverse it and slam them into the ceiling and then dismiss the spell and slam them back in the ground?
I mean, I kind of did that last time, but it didn't work with the ones that didn't burrow into the ceiling immediately.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I'm with you.
I wonder if I cast, like, Find Steed, if one of these things would become my...
you just tame one and ride it around?
Yeah,
dude.
Dwarf, dwarf riding a bullet, you know?
It's worth a shot. It'd take one of them out of the mix and you'd have them out.
Yeah. I don't think it works that way.
You'd probably get like a dire pig.
I'd be okay with that.
I think it has a wereboar?
Like the shadow realm or something.
He just turns around and looks at you like, huh. Huh, fine.
You're
tea.
Not
that,
riding
that's,
me into battle.
That's interesting. I have a question, James.
Sure.
That ravine that rope bridge crosses, is that walls on those sides, or does it just kind of carry on in the distance?
It goes off in the distance.
Okay.
You think that's the way to go?
It's a potential, but I think it's a... also a potential dead end with a whole lot of hard work.
We could always try questioning this handler, dude.
Yeah, but how do we question him without being attacked by those guys?
So I could pretend to be an Earth Cult member, and I still have Earth and Grasp, so I could use that potentially as proof. I could be like, I'm new here, and I'm supposed to bring an offering to blah blah blah, Ogremok or whoever.
Do we have any uniforms?
Do they have uniforms?
Yeah.
We did pick up the armor. Remember that weird spiky armor looking shit?
Oh.
I think it's probably a little bit big for her, but...
So, I could try that and see if he'll at least tell us which direction to go. And then...
We could be prisoners you're escorting?
We just need to go fight these things. Come on. Come on, how hard can it be?
Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and change this now.
Sort of heavily armored. How hard could it be? James just queues up.
in Feng Shui, there's actually bad guys where those cliche questions makes them stronger.
Oh, great. What's the worst that could happen?
Yeah.
Death blow.
Just go get him.
Touch of death to you, finger of death to you, disintegrate to you.
It has some suggestions like, well, at least I can't use guns. Wait, they can use guns
what
now?
What? What are guns?
Come on.
Well,
you guys were running away from hook horrors, or we're afraid to go fight the bullets. Let's just go. Come on.
If we're going to do that, let's at least be smart about it and split up and try to...
No.
Hit them from both sides.
No, we don't split up.
Splitting
the
party always works well.
Bad idea.
Oh, come on, no.
Bad
seriously.
Idea.
Because either we flank them
heads,
or
right?
They flank us.
Hey, what?
They have big heads and big mouth.
I'm moving
his description.
Hey, you overgrown cave gherkin, quit playing with your wee pets and tell me how to get out of here.
Well,
is that
it's on now.
Okay, you approach from down there? Or from up there?
Yep.
Oh, I guess we're going. Oh, can I at least cast something first?
Negative, it's too late.
You kind of...
No. If we're going to have this talk, we're going to do this the right way.
Yeah, I mean, I guess as they're talking, you can be like, ah, oh, shit, and then you go ahead and cast it.
Baracle's going to dash.
You're also going to have plus 2 to AC.
Oh, sweet. Is that
Shield
haste?
Of Faith. No, oh. Shield of Faith. I don't
You're
have
awesome.
Haste.
All right. I should be able to get there with a double move and dash.
Okay. Call it the Ape Gherkin.
Why'd that happen? Can you see them?
I can see one bullet and one guy. Oh, and yeah, I can see them all. There's
okay.
Four there.
What is a roar grin?
Why does it keep on disappearing when I click?
Yeah, they're gone now.
What's happening?
Maybe it's because we don't have line of sight. There's one. There's two.
I'm
three.
I'm redoing them. try to do them correctly. And okay. Cool. So yeah. Rogan. That's Rogan. Rorgrin. Too many R's. He's not allowed to have that many R's in his name. Rorgan. Turns around. He was like, well, the obvious way is to die.
I guess it's initiative, huh?
Sure.
Yeah.
I mean, unless you want to continue that conversation.
Where's that dude?
I'm on initiative anyway.
He's the smaller creature in the middle.
Oh, okay.
Lucas, are you rolling your niche?
Ooh, nice.
There you go.
Oh, finally.
So, Lucas, what are you doing?
Yeah, of course. Well, I'm just going to kind of hang back right at the entrance for right at the moment.
Okay.
Did I want to do anything else? We'll say no for now. That'll be my turn.
Okay. This creature, I'm going to flip him over saying that he burrowed down. He's underground. Barracle.
How did we do it? Holding our action? Holding initiative? What did we do?
You just state that you're going to hold your initiative, and then whenever you're ready to act, we just change your initiative to that.
Okay, that's what I'm going to do.
Okay, Rimble.
Well, it's the standard hunter's mark on... I already did it. All right, cool. Whoa, why is that like three times?
I only see two.
I see it three times also.
Okay, hold on.
Oh, yeah. No, I only see it twice.
Cool, now. Now I've only got it once.
I'll go ahead and actually remove those other two.
Already killed them.
Yeah, I know, but...
So the diagonals, are we still going, you know, 5, 10, 5, 10, like that?
No.
Just 5, 10, 15, 20?
Just 5.
Yeah, they're just 5.
Oh, really? I've been alternating.
Oh, you shouldn't.
Yeah, we...
So any diagonal is a 15... Or I'm sorry, is a 5-foot step still?
Yep.
Oh.
Yeah, we got rid of that, like, right after we came over to Fantasy Grounds.
I don't think I really ever did it.
Pappy had us doing it for a little while, and then we kind of threw it out the window.
Oh, I've always been doing it. Oops.
You should select him.
I should select.
Mm-hmm.
You are accurate. Okay, let's try again.
Still missed, but yeah.
Not much better. Whiff, whiff.
Yep.
That's all right.
He blocked you both times. Ro, what you doing?
Let's see. That's an excellent question.
Hey. What happened? Wind Vane is missing from my actions. It was there in the last fight.
What is the name? It's a spear
we got from the air god. It should be on there as a missile weapon and as a melee weapon. Did you just do something, James?
I mean, I'm flipping through your screen.
Hold on, there it is. There it is. It's back.
No, go back. Hold on, I'll fix it. I see what? you have it as a carried item instead of equipped, and now it should show.
Oh, interesting. Thank you.
Yep. Okay. So go on. Sorry, Rowena.
It's okay. I was thinking anyways. So, and I think I'm going to go ahead and cast Blink on myself.
Okay.
Yeah. And that'll be it for me. Actually, let me look at, how that Blink thing works. I have to roll a 1d20. Yeah.
And what happened? Okay. I forget.
I vanish from the current plane of existence and appear in the ethereal plane at the start of my next term and when the spell ends. Blah, blah, blah. You return to an unoccupied space of your choice that you can see within 10 feet of the space you vanished from. So okay. I have popped out of existence.
Cool. Would you use Blink?
Yes.
All right. He is also going to burrow down. He is going to start stabbing against Grimble. So, he's super quick with his spear, and he takes three different stabs at you. Two of them connect, and it looks like you were still able to hold your God's creature for both of those.
So with, like, the burrowed ones, can we still see them there, and they're just, like, part of the ground, or how does that work?
You're seeing, like, the ground move, like, you're, like, Bugs Bunny going through the ground, you're seeing the rocks, and it stuff pile up.
Can we attack them when they're like that?
I don't think so. But that's going way back.
I mean, they're decently far down, but I don't...
Unless you got some way to penetrate the earth to hit them. I don't think so.
Yeah, I don't believe you do. Unless you have something that I'm not thinking of.
Okay.
Okay, so it's gonna run down here and jump. Wham. Grimble, I need a strength or dex saving throw. I'm going to move them back here just because it's hard to select you.
Alright, and my saving throw gets a plus 3 because of my aura of protection.
Okay. So yeah, he leaps at you real quick. You're able to step out of the way as he landed. All right. You were able to roll up. What is going on here is basically you make a DC 16 and not be knocked prone. All right. So it's only going to be half damage.
I guess I'll be back in a minute.
Yeah.
Did he make it?
He did succeed. So
that was half
damage. Yeah.
And how much damage did he take?
He only took 14, but 28 is what slammed on the table.
Okay.
And he succeeded at that, so okay, cool. This thing's coming up and out of the ground.
Alright. I'm going to go ahead and take my initiative here. If you're done with your turn, James.
Sorry, I'm making sure I understand how this works. Okay, go ahead. You're taking your initiative on one?
Oh, yeah, I guess so.
Okay.
That hit.
That hits. Okay.
Dude, I'm devilish with some darts. Did that not take the damage a second time?
It looks like it did.
The same exact roll. Okay, sorry. All right, and that's it for me.
Yeah. So you start coming running out of the out of that side, and you're just
yeah, double-handed darts.
Both the darts land inside of, what were you talking, Rogan?
Yep.
Rogan. Okay. And Lucas, you're up.
Alrighty. I have a feeling this is about to get fun and interesting. I will step up here to where Rowena disappeared. Can I see Rogan from here? Do I have line of sight on him?
Yeah, because the other two are burrowed. No, they just popped up. Never mind. I'm sorry.
That one popped up. I mean, it is a large creature, but
step a couple a little bit north to get line of sight on him?
I think you could probably see around him.
Okay. Well, we'll just go ahead and step a little bit north anyway. And
now you absolutely can.
Let's see. First level, second level. Let's go third level for funsies, maybe. We'll see. Hopefully I can hit.
That
hit? Nice. What the hell did you do to him?
Boom.
Guiding bolt.
Ow.
And he's now a glowing beacon. Next attack has advantage against him.
Yeah, damn.
Nice.
Nice shot, Nathan.
So let me mark that spell.
What's that look like?
Just like a radiant beam just wham, just slams into him and makes him glow.
That's kind of what I figured. I just see it coming out of your entire tower shield like a
kind of,
like a huge column of light.
Let's see. That's that. And I think that's all I can do. Yep.
Okay. Well, now this guy. Gonna come charging out and I'm gonna make the strength save for Rick. He succeeds.
All right. I've got my kid screaming now. I'll be back in a second.
And now Grimble's up. But it looks like we're on a quick break.
Quick break.
Yep. I'm going to go ahead and grab a drink.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to make some coffee. I'm dying.
All right. See you in a minute.
Okay.
We're taking. get it washed. No, the whole thing just fits in there. Both of them. Yep. I can put both of them in there. Mm-hmm. It's awesome.
Sweet.
We got new toilets. It's kind of funny. Jamie was like, I want a toilet that's normal size. So we got the normal size toilet. Apparently our older toilets were a little bit shorter. And now she's like, my feet dangle. I'm like, I don't know how to help you.
So normal size meaning like chair height?
Yeah, the 16 inch.
That's what I put in my, well, the one in my other, the other house, the master bathroom, it was a 17 inch, which was fine for me, but not so much.
Yeah, we've got a slightly taller one upstairs than the downstairs one is normal, and Danielle likes the downstairs one, can't stand the top one. She says it makes my feet go to sleep like that.
Short people problems.
Yeah. Well, it's kind of funny because we have a bidet on them, and Jamie's like, it's not hitting me. It's not hitting me where it should. And I was like, are you sitting back on the chair? No. I was like,
it's only going to aim in one spot. It's not, it doesn't have a visual sensor to aim for a butthole. I mean, it's just.
You got a built-in targeting system.
That's nice, man.
Toilet, 150, bidet with targeting system. $2,000.
That's a good job for a Raspberry Pi or an Arduino right there.
Yeah, how would you keep that sensor clean, though? I mean, honestly, let's just say.
Research to make sure that it could actually read the butthole.
Think about the stock images that you have to find and then load into the program. Just nothing but buttholes. Jamie comes in, what are you doing?
Research.
Programming the bidet.
Trying to get the bidet to
see it's hilarious.
That's the most disturbing porn ever.
Yeah.
Okay, what's going on with my...
All right, I'm going to have to check that out later. Thanks, Aaron.
Yeah, don't mention it.
Because my wife is 5 foot, so that's just...
don't let her listen to that song.
Is that the, like... I think I know what that song. I have
the short
about.
People got no reason to live song.
Yeah,
it's that one.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
That's horrible. That's great.
Short I gotta listen people. To that.
Short people. I've seen an anime music video put to that, and it's
was
great.
It with Full Metal Alchemist?
I think so.
Yeah.
It's great.
I saw that stupid.
Oh, did you watch the people version of it?
Don't watch the live action.
Just don't do that.
Don't ever watch the anime.
That's
action of anime movies.
I didn't know it was anime.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it's a really, really, really good one. But mm-hmm. You're talking like, what is it? 48 episodes on the like Brotherhood version and 52 on the original or something.
Yeah,
like
if
that.
You have an option and you want to watch the Brotherhood one.
The Brotherhood is a little more gory and in-depth and realistic, I think, but
it's not going to happen.
It's a time investment. It's a chunk of time.
It's just not happening.
Yeah.
I don't watch anime anyways, but yeah, it's probably...
It's a really good story.
I'll take your word for it.
Then you should read the manga.
Oh yeah, because that's going to happen.
Yeah, if he's not going to watch it, he's not going to read manga.
I feel like anime is the base threshold. Reading manga is a little bit stuff.
It stands a better chance than watching, because I could like do that on the toilet. Well, I suppose I could watch on the toilet, too. I've got wireless phones and tablets. It's not happening.
That's a lot of toilet time. Aren't they hour-long
episodes?
There
you go, right there, James.
No, they're not that long.
You can program the sensor so she can aim at her own. That way you don't have to...
Yeah, great bidet equipment.
She'll just stick. It's a Bluetooth connection, and it's a camera with crosshairs on
with
it.
With a targeting reticle on it. It's a game. It's a new toilet game.
It is.
See? Congratulations.
Rick would never
come
out of the
bathroom. You
have
to build a scoring
bathroom.
Method. And...
You can call it Asteroids.
And there's a point system. get the maximum amount of points if you clear all everything. The screen is clear.
We need a Kickstarter on this, guys.
Oh, this is horrible. This is not a good idea.
I think it's an excellent idea.
I've got to bring this up, my Tuesday nights. Carrie Chamberlain and myself, we've been meeting up on Tuesday nights just to program, and we're looking for something to program. So I'm going to introduce a new program idea. It's called Asteroids.
Dude, I'm telling you, a couple of rails, some three stepper motors for an XYZ axis, a small camera, and an aquarium pump. That's all you need. You got it.
But see, here's the other aspect of that. The first time you actually play it, nobody wants to know what their own asshole looks like.
No, they don't.
We can put a fire hose on Rick's version.
Yeah, okay. Do you have nozzles on that? Is there like a fan nozzle that goes on that? How does that work? Just a solid stream's not going to do very much.
My mine feels like a friggin' fire hose. I can only get one click. I can only get one click
shower
on
shower massage on the end of it, you know? And you
just like click, 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 just change it.
Yeah. Oh, this one pulses. I can't believe.
Please tell me you're recording this for Twitch.
Oh, yeah, it's on.
Somehow we start trending just because of this conversation.
What would be weird is, if, you know, you see the product.
Yeah, exactly.
Just wait. The way that Amazon and Google spy on you, you're going to start seeing ads pop up all over the sides of your Facebook and everything else now.
Twitch and Amazon are a partner. So.
Oh, that's just great.
That's true.
Oh, I needed that, guys.
All right, let's fight some dudes.
So what happened? I had to walk away. My kid rolled out of bed, so I had to.
Okay. Basically, these things started trying to attack you. One of them missed.
Right.
The other one, I think, got just a bite attack on you. I don't remember. I have to scroll up a little bit.
They were jumping at you to try and knock you prone.
Yep. They weren't doing well.
No, it didn't. Okay. Cool. I only see one save, though, for me.
The
other one didn't try to flatten you.
I think the attack missed on the other one, so you didn't have to save for prone.
Okay. Bonus. So whose turn is it now? Mine?
You're
up.
Okay.
Oh, and the Rorgrim guy or whatever on the tiny one, mm-hmm. He's glowing like a shiny little beacon, so you have advantage on the first strike.
Yep.
Oh,
he's got a couple of darts sticking out of his ass, and he's... Dude, he hit him for 33 points with Guiding Bolt.
What? Dang.
Yeah. So he's got 40 points of damage already.
Oh, he's already... Okay, so I'm not going to waste what I was going to do. It's advantage on the next attack. Anyway, so awesome. Do I need a select advantage or just make my...
It should automatically apply it. It's got the effect on him, so...
Ah, bueno. All right. Well, let's do this. There it is.
That hits.
All right.
And now that burns out the advantage. It doesn't stick for your whole round, but...
Jamie just got home.
Nice.
Did I hurt him?
A little bit.
Just a little.
Let's try it again.
Nice.
That hits.
Okay. That hurt him.
I think that did the job.
How do you kill this guy?
Jesus. I'm dodging and weaving, rolling out of the way, trying to avoid these bullets, and I just come up from one of my forward rolls, axe in hand, and just double swipes at him. You know, just. Big X across his chest, you know, his entrails spill out. Sounds like good times.
Nice. I'm sorry, hang on a second.
Is that woad on his face? That is? Is that woad on James's face?
No.
Woad? What is woad?
It's like the
his LARP character.
Stuff. Yeah, it's the bluish stuff that Celts used to put on their faces to go into battle.
I don't think it's that. I'm pretty sure it's just paint.
Well, yeah, but is that what he was going for, I guess is what I'm asking.
I think it's a specific marking that one of his LARP characters had.
Okay.
If I remember correctly. I don't know. I asked about it a long time ago.
Aaron.
You're...
You look exactly like your mama.
Yeah.
I saw that, your Facebook stuff. I'm really sorry.
Thanks.
Yeah, you guys are like, I was like, wow. It's like a mirror.
Yeah, I always felt like her mini-me, so...
Hmm.
It was
good.
Like, it really is.
Yeah.
She's a pretty lady.
Yeah, I hope I age as well.
All right, sorry about that. All right, so yeah, your two axe attacks against them. Basically, like the first one slams down. Like he has a spear. The first one comes through and just cuts right through his arms, and he's, of course, sitting there, like, screaming with these nubs, and then you just bring your axe back around straight across the face and drop to the ground.
So much for us dying.
Well,
I mean, we're not done yet, but at least he was the one talking trash about where you could die.
Yeah. I didn't expect him to go down so fast, but good job. I appreciate that.
I am first going to unmute myself, and then when I blink back into existence, I'm going to blink there,
okay,
and then 5 foot step there, and use Investiture of Flame on myself, which I don't know if this will do it or not. Let's see, what is this? No, that's not the same. You're just going to have to know that it's on me, because I don't have an effect to put on myself.
Okay. What is it?
Okay, so it's slightly complicated, but it... a concentration spell that lasts up to 10 minutes. Flames are all over my body, shedding bright light for 30 feet and dim light for an extra 30 feet. I don't get harmed by them, and I'm immune to fire damage and have resistance to cold damage, not that that matters. Any creature that moves within 5 feet of me for the first time on a turn or ends its turn there takes 1d10 fire damage, and then I get an action that I can do, which is to create a line of fire that's 15 feet long and 5 feet wide, extending from me in any direction I choose. Each creature in that line must make a dex saving throw. If they fail, they take 48 fire damage or half as much on a successful save.
That's pretty badass.
That's really kind of baller. You're just like fire laser beam all day long.
Pew! Yeah, that's pretty much, I figured it would save me some spells, so.
And they can't really approach you either. That's nice.
They can, so the only thing is, like, since I have Blink on me now, it is slightly less effective, but at least if I am not blinked out, if they decide to attack me, they will regret it. So, right.
Can't you just end Blink?
It is not a concentration spell. It just lasts for a minute. So,
okay.
I don't know...
Like, can't you just end Blink? Or are you
she
saying...
She could if she wanted to, but I think she...
Can I?
I don't see why not. I mean, you can keep it. I'm not... But...
Like, can I choose not to blink? Like, I can keep it on, but just choose not to...
You can't choose not to blink. You could choose to drop it, though.
Okay. Yeah, I'm just gonna keep it on.
That's fine.
So, yeah, I'm going to...
Actually, no, Investiture of Flame is a concentration spell.
Yeah, but Blink isn't.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, cool. Okay.
So. I don't want a square. I guess I'm just. Can I draw an arrow?
You shoot it straight ahead of you, you'll hit two of them.
That's what I'm planning on doing. Okay, I can't draw anything that'll show that. But that's what I'm doing. So it's going to hit these two. one. Oh, I didn't mean to have myself selected. Ignore that. Ignore
she
myself.
Had
I had
targeted.
Yeah. Okay.
She shot
then...
her flame whip at the two bullets.
Did they make their save?
One success, one failed.
It should do it automatically.
Yep, they took care of it.
Okay, cool. And then I will roll to see if I blink. Phew. I do blink, so I am poofed.
Okay.
Although, does this one take, since I cast that and move next to him? That was actually going to be a question I had for you, because it says, any creature that moves within 5 feet of you for the first time on a turn or ends its turn there takes 1d10. Since I moved into next to him, does he still take that?
No, only because of how the wording says.
If he's there at the end of his turn, he will.
Well, but I'm not technically there, so.
She's in a different plane, so that's right.
Yeah, I guess they did that so you can't be on fire and
just run in circles around people.
Well, no, the whole somebody grabs you and starts levitating you around in a circle between the people.
You mean we can't play Duck Duck Goose with her just running around lighting people on fire?
I mean, that would be kind of funny.
Hit her with the Rowena! Alright. This thing is now going to pop out of the ground. And it's going to see, hey, there's more people now. I'm just random decision. Okay. It is going to run down and attack a bear cult.
Okay. Did he hit a 19?
He hit a 25.
Well, I guess that'll do.
He jumps up and claws and then fights down. And he missed with the claws, but got with the bite.
Okay.
this. Damn it. All right, this one's going to continue attacking Grimble. And it misses. You're up.
I think I'm just going to piss this thing off. Take this. Oh,
that hit?
Hit.
Yep.
Cool. Take that. I'm going to spend a key point.
Sweep the leg, Johnny.
Well, speaking of, I finally watched that Cobra Kai on YouTube. It's actually pretty good.
I watched the two when they were free. I haven't watched the whole thing, but I liked the first two episodes. Aren't they all free now? Didn't YouTube drop its like subscription thing?
I'm not sure. I watched it on my friend's Plex server.
Huh. I'm assuming you don't
disengage so you could throw darts at it.
I hit one, ran around him, and threw a dart at a different one.
Okay.
Did you disengage?
I did. Step of the wind.
Oh. So he doesn't get an attack of opportunity?
No, he doesn't.
Okay.
It is considered a disengage, but it takes a key point to do. And it's a bonus action, so I don't get my flurry of blows. So I only get two attacks that round.
Okay.
And that's it.
Alright. It's going to bite at Grimble. It bites you, and it catches you off guard. It seems like you lost your concentration.
Didn't work out too well for that hook whore that did that last time. I'm gonna move up here. see if I can start swinging on this dude here.
That hits.
Plus, use that. And I'm going to do something I haven't done very often. We're going to make a spiritual weapon. And that also hits.
Nice.
So, I have a floating, glowing mace beside me, twirling around, slamming down on this thing also.
It sounded like a bladed weapon, like a sword or something.
It's a sword mace.
Maces tend to not make sound effects until they hit stuff.
It sounds like somebody hitting a side of beef with a meat tenderizing hammer.
And that's going to be my turn.
Oh, I got to mark off another couple of darts. I got all my darts back when we rested for some reason.
You pick them up after a fight.
Well, there's three of them I couldn't pick up.
I was going to say, there's three at the bottom of that ravine.
Yeah, you might want to pick those off.
Yeah. And I just threw three. So, yeah.
That really should be its own button. all right, so he's going to attack the Sleekus and floating thing. And he misses. He's distracted by that.
Twirly, glowy mace.
That twirly, glowy mace. Yes.
He can attack that all day long if he wants. He can't do anything to it.
All right, Grimble.
All right. Mr. Young Bullet 10 there decided to hit me, so I'm going to hit him back. And I'm uttering a vow of enmity against him. That'll do it.
Hit.
Okay. Let's see how he likes this. Oh, shit. All right. Screwed up. Okay.
So move the 17 so you can re-roll that, or?
Nope.
Okay.
Okay. Second attack.
Okay.
How's that?
Yeah, you crushed right. It.
Yeah, don't hit me again.
It won't. yep. Your axe came straight down into its head.
And through it.
Yep, plowed right through it. As you pull the axe back out, you hear the shell crack, and as it falls to the ground, dies.
Yeah.
Eggs, anybody?
I wasted a vow of enmity on him, but it was worth it. Satisfaction is mine.
But he didn't have much damage before, did he? Oh, shit.
Okay, I'm going to blink into existence there. Oh, crap.
I'm sorry, did I add a special note?
Her flame girl?
Yes.
I saw that.
I gave her an effect.
You know what? I take it back. Blink in here. Can I do this? I'm going to do this as a diagonal to hit these two.
Sure. What are you casting?
My flame wall thing.
Oh, okay.
Pew!
One succeed and one failed.
If I move, actually, yeah, I'm going to move right here,
okay.
I guess, just in the off chance that I don't disappear. see if I do. Did that deselect the other one? No, it looks like it did do damage to both. Okay, never mind. Alright. I did poof. Poof.
So, the time I needed you to poof, you couldn't. This time you can't not poof.
Yep.
Oops.
Sorry.
No, you're fine. This thing's gonna run up and start attacking Barrel. Yep, it jumps and pounces at you, claws its feet into the ground, takes a bite. You duck and weave out of the way. He is going to put his attack down on Grimble. Misses.
That's smart. That was smart.
Fair goal.
Okay. Attack. Is that a hit?
That hit.
All right. And let's try this. Whoa, just the first one.
Try to figure out what all happened here.
I double clicked instead of single clicking.
You do that a bunch.
Okay, he failed.
When I go to that. Say again?
He failed and you hit.
He failed and I hit. Okay. What happens is when I click on my normal attacks, it's a single or a double click to roll. When I do my spell effects, it's just a single click to roll. So I get used to doing one and then I double click the other.
Your spell effects are a button. Your attacks aren't. I don't know. I'm trying to help.
Yeah, I mean, when I double click, if you look at my screen, you'll see
what I'm doing. Yeah, I know.
And I don't really know how to do it differently. But anyway, he's prone.
Okay.
Yes. Okay, so here's the damage on that. And that's the third attack. This is an advantage. Ooh, natural nice. 20.
Nice.
So how do you kill it?
He comes up and he tries to bite me. I duck and dodge. I kick his front leg out. I knee him in the face. And then I come down with a hammer strike. Just foul right on the top of his head and crack his little armored plating.
Absolutely. Nice.
And then I'm going to move. How's everybody doing on health? I'm going to move up here. Just maybe as a distraction to get him off a Grimble.
Okay. Lucas.
I'm just going to step around just a smidge here. Kind of back-to-back to Grimble so that he can't be flanked somehow. And I'm going to take some more swings on this little one in front of me here. That hit?
That hit.
I was a lot more worried about this these things.
Yeah, they were young. They're not.
And then, so the spiritual weapon attacks again.
Hits.
Nice.
And that's my turn.
All right. Try again. Misses. I'm not doing very well. All right, Grimble.
All right. Attacking the big boy. is it fancy this time? Ooh.
Mm-hmm.
Is 16 gonna do it?
16 is not gonna do it.
Not okay. Damn.
No. His armor plating is too strong.
Got it. Let's see. Can I do anything here?
I keep hearing somebody's phone?
No,
I think it's in the background music.
There's this weird flashing for some reason.
Yeah, alright, man, go ahead.
I actually picked out something for these guys. I forgot to switch. Alright, Ro, what you done?
I'm going to poof back into existence right here. And go Flameo Hotman right up this way.
That'll hit them both again. Damn. Good job, Rowena.
Thank you.
Pew. One failed, one succeeded.
Pew.
All right.
Got a girl. Nice.
And then. Poof. I bought about existence.
Yeah. Poof, 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 poof. You shot your firebolt, or whatever it is, that flame that shoots out.
A flame wall.
When it passed through the first one, and it hit the second one, and it got him just right, and you see it basically just kind of like open up where its neck is, and it drops.
Blur.
He hit.
He got me this time. Wow, he hit hard that time.
Yeah. When they finally hit, it hurts. It's apparently the thing that you need for it to happen.
He will pay.
Alright, Barakal.
Alright, I'm gonna go with the same thing I did last time. Yep.
That's not what you did last time. You actually hit that time.
Yeah, I know. I did it again. It's the first one.
Okay, so he succeeded.
I think it missed anyway, though.
I didn't hit on either one.
Yeah.
So the last two are just straight attacks.
Miss? This is nothing like last time.
Whiff, 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 whiff.
No, actually, it's more like you just jump on it, you just start pounding at it, and its shell is just so hard.
Dude, I don't know if any of those would have... Okay, maybe two of them would have actually hit any others, I think, are whiffs.
Knuckle dusters.
I will step around, and we're going to continue doing what seems to be working for the other ones.
Okay.
Not with that, it's not.
You guys got to quit saying that stuff. I'm going to go with what's working. I want to do the same thing I did last time.
I'm going to step back and throw darts at him.
The mace is going to move over a little bit in the air, and we're going to see if we can't crack him on the head.
Okay.
No, I did the same thing. Well, neither one of those would have worked, so we're doing awesome. Awesome.
Welcome to my world.
You might want to also select him.
That would probably make a difference, too. Not that it matters this round. But...
All right, Grumble.
Shit.
Okay. What the?
Unbelievable.
What the hell just happened this round?
We wiped up all of the little ads, and the one dude takes the rest of the party.
Rowena, wow. None of the melee guys can hit him. Take him out. Apparently, we're useless. It's like somebody cursed us. James is rolling random stuff here.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. He's trying to figure out who's getting attacked next.
What are you doing, Ralph?
Oh, it's my turn. I'm so sorry. I was just like spacing out. Pop. Nope. Too many rotations. There we go.
Yep, so it failed.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8 shots. None of us hit him. Rowena blinks into existence, goes boom.
And a poof away.
And in her place is standing a unicorn.
It's seriousness, was that like a wild magic thing, or that yep. just...
There is a
real
unicorn.
Like a legit real, not just like an image of a unicorn.
A legit unicorn is standing there.
Wow. Don't piss him off, guys.
You did do fine, Steed.
I could have, yeah. There we go. A dwarf paladin riding a freaking unicorn.
I hear the horn is a great aphrodisiac.
A little horny.
Not yet. Does a 17 hit? Thank God. Yeah. Okay. Shit. Any penalty on that? That's just a whiff.
Yeah, not misses.
Team misses too, right?
Yeah.
There we go.
There you go.
Take him out. Gotta keep sitting
here. Nope. Okay. I need the screen here, sorry. Oop. Oh, right. Sorry.
You're fine.
Tears to kill.
Go ahead, Lucas. There you go.
There it is, man. There it is.
Thank God.
Oh.
Just for fun.
Describe its death.
So the hammer just kind of lights up, and I'm just going to bring it up from under his chin. And it's actually kind of like a war pick, so I'm just going to use the pointy part of it and just bring it up from under him.
Oh, nice. Nice.
That's what we should have been.
I'm going to poof back and be sitting on the unicorn.
Oh,
yes, you are.
Just give it a little pat.
Baracle's just gonna look over there, and he's just gonna be like, "What? What the hell, Rowena?
Look what I found!"
The unicorn starts heading north.
Oh, okay, we're going this way, guys.
Which way? Top left or?
Top left.
We're following the unicorn.
Are we really?
Since it's kind of kidnapping Rowena since she's on top of it.
Well, oh, and so also... Oops, I didn't mean to do that. I don't even know how I did that.
I was going to say, you were looking for the arrow earlier. And
I found the arrow!
Oh, God. I don't know.
Magic continues to strike.
Okay, well...
You need me to kill
throwing
it?
Arrows.
Yeah, you can... If you get rid of it, please. Thank you. Also, Leocus, I am shedding light for a while, so you shouldn't have a problem seeing.
I was going to say, you are kind of on fire. I'm assuming the unicorn does not matter, does not mind that you're on fire.
I don't think so, no. Okay.
Well, we have a pretty impressive sight in front of us. a flaming... Fox lady on top of a unicorn.
It's the unicorn.
Pretty sure most things are going to be slightly intimidated. Just
the unicorn
seeing that
taking
coming around
the damage.
Corner. No, it seems to be fine.
Wow.
It seems to be completely fine with what's happening.
I'm on an elbow, Grimmels. Are you seeing this? Did I get hit in the head too hard?
I mean, both are probably true. Alright, by the time you guys get up into this room, it poofs.
Does she just kind of fall on the ground?
Yeah, she just falls. And she can probably land on her feet. She's used to this thing.
Alright.
Do you guys want me to stealth and check?
North or right? We do need to start maybe attempting to head east a little bit.
Check both directions.
Okay.
All right. Where are you going?
Sneak up here and see what I see. That's my stealth check that was just rolled.
Yep.
Sneak up to here. Peek around.
Zoomed out far enough.
Do I see or hear anything in that room?
Nope. The room is, it's just a large, open cavern, supported by the six columns in the middle.
And I don't hear anything and see anything?
Not in here, but you definitely hear like a lot of stones moving towards the east.
Okay. I'm going to come down and peek this direction. Peek both directions.
That was a bad drawing. Man. I suck at this tonight.
All right, I'm going to peek down here.
Hold on. Down in this room, you see two people, well, two stone melders. They look like they're working on armor. Hmm. Look like the Earth Cult's armor.
Okay. But that's really it, huh? Okay. I'll sneak back, tell the party what I've seen. And tell them that to the room north of us is a very large cavern. And I hear a lot of rock fall, rock movement to the northeast of that cavern. The cavern itself seems to be empty, and I'll tell them about the two guys in armor below. Or the two guys making armor below.
Do we want to ignore those two guys for now?
No, man, I say we go incapacitate him.
And by incapacitate, you mean gank?
Sure.
That's not really the direction towards our ideal goal destination, though, because we're going to be going further south.
Is that the same kind of armor I saw in the orcs back in my origin story there, James?
Yes, and you've seen it since then as well.
Okay. I'm all for going down and taking them out.
I mean, I say we go and take them out, and it's like no one says we have to continue down that path. I just don't want to leave them
come up behind
us. Where they might come up behind us.
Okay.
I think that sounds reasonable. I'm gonna just tap you on the shoulder.
Okay, I gotta make a pit stop. I'll be back.
Do you want to take five?
If you guys want to.
Might as well. I gotta take a pit stop too.
That wasn't as good as I hoped, but.
Alright. I'll be right back.
see them like reach out just into the air, and they the earth actually pulls stone from the ground, and they take and they dip it into this boiling mud that you see there in the middle, and then they lift it and they start shaping it and molding it and dip it back down.
Can you place the guys?
Sure. I think that I might be able to pull up tokens for them. I can just grab two random tokens and place them.
Oh, sorry. I didn't realize my mic was down. He's happy kitty right now. Getting all the cheek scratches.
There.
Oh, their backs are turned. I'm going stealth.
Those are really good tokens.
Yeah, they are. Just for pulling them out of your butt.
The app helped with that.
Yeah, absolutely. There's a token folder, and I just went in there and I found two tokens and I grabbed them and threw them in there.
Okay. Veracle's gonna sneak up watching them, and if they see me, it's gonna be, you know, a rush forward and a sidekick to knock one of them into the boiling mud.
It did not happen. They did not see you.
I'm going to get right here. And first. Knockback says I kick them away from me. Do I have the option just to kick the guy into the pit with like a roundhouse?
Divert yeah.
The force to the east? Okay.
Absolutely. They're both going in there then. I mean, they aren't even level one characters.
Oh,
so
okay.
If you want to just end them, you can end them.
Then I am going to, you know, double roundhouse, just pow, and then a hook kick, pow, knock them both into the mud.
Okay, yeah. Just, pow, pow. When they hit the mud, like, the mud is boiling. And so, like, they start screaming, and they just start getting drowned down into
I'm
the
mud. I'm just going to kind of cross my arms and watch.
Shh. Just like slowly pushing one of them under. Shh. No, it's okay. Shh. Just relax.
Yep.
And now I'm gonna search the room.
I guess now that I've, can I see that far?
Sure.
Because I had moved up.
We probably heard the screaming.
Well. Yeah. But I see that he's fully resolved the current situation. I'm just gonna go ahead and move on in.
And I'll just peek around this corner, see if anybody heard the screams.
You guys find a breastplate in there? I just dropped it in the party sheet.
Cool. Is there anything of interest below us here, James? Peeking around the corner.
Yes, there's a small empty cave. I will open it up.
Do we want to explore this level, or do we want to go fight the god being?
I think we want to go back up in northeast. We just wanted to make sure that they didn't backtrack on us.
Okay. So, here's my question for you guys. It's 12:30. Do we want to start this now?
No.
Okay.
I think it would be a bad idea.
We're at the correct room now.
Yeah. So yes.
Well, so he peeks and he tells us what's in there, and we
back
up in camp.
We can do that.
Sure.
Yes.
Ooh, that was fun.
Wow. That's a big damn room. Do you have a description for that room?
Yeah, I'm working on it.
Okay.
Okay. The cavern has like a... Oh, man. There is a picture. I should be able to get this loaded. Where is it?
I mean, we're here. We can stay up till 3 in the morning. It's okay.
To go through all of these pictures. It is a cool picture. I want you guys to see it. But it's not jumping out to me in here. No. All right. So inside the cavern is kind of like it's very alien in nature. Like, things are floating, like mountains and rocks are floating, trying to find where I left off. And the room is all connected. You see those columns that are in there. The columns are twisting. So, like, some of them will go up and bend over and connect to other, like, mountains that are floating up there. The height of the room, it looks, like, looking up, it almost looks like the sky. You think that you can kind of make out the earth on the other side, but it is just insanely large. The long path of steps, is cut into the uneven floor, and it takes you to the stone pillar that you see up ahead. Inside you hear, like, it sounds like thunder, but you are probably imagining that it's just crashing rocks into each other. And then at the pillar, you see a man standing there, like, he's looking up at this mountain, and he's calling out to something named Orgmoth. The god named Orgmoth. And he's calling out to the god named Orgmoth standing at the base of this mountain. And you could see his hair is all snakes. And
great.
That's what you see in there.
Like Medusa type?
Yep. Baracle, you recognize him from your vision when you saw all the different princes.
Gotcha. And this is the guy with the big hammer, is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
And I guess this is a good spot to leave this. And you guys will start next game, hopefully charging into this room and picking at the monster.
Can we assume we take a long rest before then?
Sure.
Okay.
Okay.
Because Grimble needs some healing, and I would like some of my spells back.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Just in case.
Yeah, you guys are going to need it.
Sure, I can lay on hands and then
rest.
Long rest, heal. Yeah, I'll be fine.
Yeah.